today I am going to read to you The Detective Dog. I hope you enjoy. There once was a dog with a keen sense of smell. She was known far and wide as Detective Dog Nell. Sniff, 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 time after time, Nell the detective solved crime after crime. Who threw the hazelnuts down from the trees? Who took the honey away from the bees? Who did the poo on the new gravel path? How did the spider get into the bath? Sniff, sniff, sniff with a wag of a tail. Nell the detective was hot on the trail. Nell shared a house with a person called Peter, a very nice boy, though he could have been neater. And six-year-old Peter was one of those boys who kept on mislaying his clothes and his toys. Sniff, 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 nose to the ground. These are the things the detective dog found. The bus in the bowl and the book in the bed. Sock in the sofa and the shoe in the shed, the tumble down teddy and the bounce away ball. Now the detective discovered them all. Nell did detection from Tuesday till Sunday, but did something totally different each Monday. She found Peter's bag and she tracked down her lead, then set off for school where she heard the children read. The children loved reading their stories to Nell, and Nell loved to listen and also to smell. Sniff, 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 mixed in the air were plasticine, custard and newly washed hair. The crusts in the bins and the coats on the hooks, but the best smell of all was the smell of the books. Books about dinosaurs, books about knights, books about planets and meteorites, books about princes who turn into frogs, and books about dragons, and books about dogs. But then came a Monday when all was not well. Nell sniffed the air and she smelled the wrong smell. To the classroom, the two of them hurried and found Mr. Jones looking terribly worried. He tugged at his hair and he let out a sigh. Peter looked round and he started to cry. Sniff, 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 what was going on? The books, cried out Peter, the books have all gone. Gave a growl when she heard the bad news, but then started sniffing and searching for clues. Sniff, 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 on the bookshelf a cap. The thief must have left it, the terrible chap. Well, Nell sniffed the cap, then she tugged on the lead, and woof, she was off with astonishing speed. Everyone followed Detective Dog Nell. She stopped at the traffic lights, what could she smell? Sniff, 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 haddock and hay, pizza and penguins and further away, the smell of the thief and how very exciting, thousands of pages all covered with writing. then woof, they were off with no time for a stop, past the farm and the zoo and the takeaway shop. They raced through a field where the rabbits smelled good, then over a golf course and into a wood. Thrashed through the undergrowth, leafy and dense, till they came to a gate in an old wooden fence. The nail started growling and pricked up an ear. She barked, and the bark meant the thief is in here. They flung the door open and Peter cried, "Look!" For there sat a man with his nose in a book. There were many more books poking out of a sack, and the children yelled, "Those are our books, give them back!" Sniff, 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 the book thief looked sad. "I'm sorry," he sniffed, "I know I've been bad. Stealing is wrong and I just meant to borrow. I was planning to give all your books back tomorrow." To borrow, Nell pricked up an ear. She barked, and the bark meant, "I've had an idea." Then woof, she was off, and away they all sped, including the book thief who told them, "I'm Ted." Sniff, 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 they raced through the wood and over the field where the rabbit smelled good. Panted and puffed past the takeaway shop. The zoo and the farmyard with never a stop, except to retrieve Peter's scarf and his ball, which someone had thoughtfully placed on a wall. Till they came to a building where the doors opened wide. But what did they see when they all went inside? Thousands of books from the floor to the ceiling. The books gave the thief the most heavenly feeling. He gazed in amazement, "Where am I?" he said. And Peter replied, "In the library, Ted. You can join if you want to, there isn't a fee. And you can take lots of books out for free." Ted has a lovely new library card, and he sits reading books in his little backyard. When it's a Monday, Detective Dog Nell visits the school with the wonderful smell. Sniff, 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 with a faraway look, she smells and she listens to book after book. Books about dinosaurs, books about knights, books about planets and meteorites, books about princes who turn into frogs, and books about dragons and books about dogs. All of the old books and a new one as well. The story of daring Detective Dog Nell. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.